Hi, welcome to Robojax. In this video, I'm going to introduce this HC-SR501 motion sensor to detect motions either on LED that shows and also or on the screen that shows it is detected, and based on that you can do some action to control something or a robotic car or arm. So this is the module. It's 32 by 24 millimeter, and it can work with 5 to 20 volts. So underneath of this, when I remove it, actually this is the actual module, LHI778. So this is the actual module that does the work, but they also put some circuitry to make it a module ready to be used by robotics applications. So it can be used as a burglar alarm, robotics application, any application that requires motion detector. Covering is for reflection of infrared. So this works based on infrared, and this covering makes the reflection very active, effective. So from every direction it can reflect it and direct it to the actual lens, to this lens. So this module has three main pins here that you can connect, and these pins are labeled here when you remove this cover. So we have three pins here. These three pins can be connected to VCC. This is VCC, this is ground, and this is output. This module can be used without Arduino because this is totally standalone, and the output will go high, or it will send a 3.3 volts TTL voltage out when it detects a motion, and it sends zero when there is no detection. So you don't need an Arduino. Actually, without Arduino it can be used. You just need to supply a battery and then connect this to a buzzer or to something based on your application. And this has also three other components that can be selected. The first one is this jumper. By default, if it's at this corner, as you can see, this is a single trigger. It means that once this detects a motion of something, and that motion will be detected and the output will go high, and it will just turn off even if the moving object continues moving. So if you want continuous trigger, then you put it here. So it continuously detect and send high and high and high. But if you put it here, one move will send the output high and then it goes low. So this is for single, and here on the next position is for continuous motion. And then here we have a sensitivity. This, you can adjust it so the sensitivity can be high or low. So that way you can play with this to see how far this can go and detect. This can detect up to 7 meter distance, according to a manual that I've searched online, and the manual also will be provided with the code when you click at the description to download the code. And then we have another potentiometer here. This potentiometer also can be adjusted to select the time delay. The time delay is the amount of time between each detection. So if you select this to be continuously or very quick detect, it will detect. Or if you can make it so it can delay it between the detection. So this is the sensitivity, this is the time delay. Another important thing that you should know about this has a voltage regulator here that adjusts it for the internal 5 volt application of this, for the 3.3 volts that this operates. So when you connect the voltage here, it has a diode that protects it even if you connect it in reverse. Let's say you connect the, instead of VCC and ground, and you just switch it so you can connect here ground, and if you connect the VCC, usually electronic components will die, but this one has a diode that protects it. So this allows only the positive here, so it can go from anode to the cathode of the diode and then to the voltage regulator. So this is a voltage regulator. As you can see here, VCC is connected to 5 volts of Arduino, and then I've connected the ground, this wire, The ground is also connected to the ground. And then the yellow, which is the signal here, is connected here at the pin 2. Then from pin 8, the green wire is now connected to the long pin, which is a positive or anode of LED, and the cathode of LED is connected to the 680 ohm resistor from here, which is connected to the ground. So this LED will turn on. So the positive will come this way and enter the LED and then goes from this resistor goes to the ground. So here is the code. The code is very simple. Inside the setup, I have set this serial monitor for 9600 baud to display the information here. And then I've set up pin 2 as an input. This is where you can connect your sensor, the middle wire from the sensor to this pin. And then pin 8 is an output. So when it detects, we will send this pin to high so we can turn on some alarm or LED on for now. And this is the loop, the main loop that goes and checks it. So this digital read will read the pin 2 that we set here as an input. So this reads pin 2 and put the result in motion. So this variable integer holds either 1 or 0. 1 mean detection, 0 mean nothing. So here we say F motion, this motion. We could also do F motion equal 1, which is extra. So if motion 1, also it means if motion is 1 automatically, then we say print this on the screen, motion detected, which will print this text. And also we say at the same time set pin 8 high. So if this is connected to an LED, LED will be turned on, alarm or some servo, whatever, you can just control it. And then else, otherwise else, just print nothing moves. And then set the pin 8, which was high, set it to low. This is the delay that I have chosen to go with, 500 milliseconds, which is half a second. So for your application, you might adjust this if you want faster or slower detection. Otherwise, every twice a second, it will detect. And when it reaches here, it goes back and this loop continues. Now I've connected it. So as you can see here, the LED is off and there is no detection. Yeah, my hand somewhere moved, so it just detected it. So now I put it in the continuous one, in the continuous mode, meaning it continuously checks and detects. So this was introduction to HC-SR501 motion sensor. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video and also please share it, and also subscribe to get updates. All the code will be provided by clicking at the description. You can get it, or you can go directly to robojax.com/learn/Arduino.